This is Calabash Community, and at this time we head back to Blesha, and to Fokoli to be exact. We get there just as a special ceremony is about to begin. Our host, Indian High Priestess Anna Sadu.
They can't even tell me good day. Oh, how are you? They're stressed out, you know. I can see the majority of people in St. Lucia right now is stressed out.
Tell us where we are, first of all. We noticed we are at a temple. Where is this temple and how did it get here?
This temple is residing in Sheik, that is Fokoli, Sheik Deriso, that is quarter of Miko, St. Lucia. Yeah. And it's my faith and my belief, so I just wanted to work it out. I can't have a faith and don't work it out, you know, so I had to put it out. And then I built the temple to teach human beings what they left behind, you know, because that was the first, and it will be the last also. As the first knowledge from God, how to love Him, how to obey Him, and how to live with Him, and it will be the last also. So that's why I had to put up something to show the people my faith, and many others right now, today is their faith. What is a surrendered soul? I mean, if you do imagine well all your life, you should surrender to the Lord, you know, and stop it, you know. These are the things God is saying, surrender. Yeah.
So you said you built it yourself, or how did you get this building up here?
I built it alone, without the help of nobody. Nobody never put $1 out of it, nothing. I built it alone, and I continue finishing it, because it's my faith.
So who are the people who come here to worship, or I don't know how you describe it, who are the people who come here?
Well, as it's the only Indian temple, so everybody from India, from Guyana, Trinidad, they come here and worship, you know. And St. Lucian also, who join, they worship in here also, you know. Like Spartan University, like Brow, like SNS, like different workers of the Indian, the doctors from St. Jude, they come here also and worship. Here is a place of worship for them, you know, because that's the only Indian temple in the area, in St. Lucia.
So what are the days of worship?
The days of worship, we worship every morning 4:30 and every Sunday at 12. So we feed everybody also every Sunday.
Why you had those fruits there, and what was happening with those fruits and the nuts and the rice and everything else?
Well, when I call the demigods, the fire gods, then I offer them fruits and vegetables and nuts and grains, seeds and grains, I offer them. That's what you have with love, you offer them when you call upon them.
This event was dedicated, you said, to St. Lucia. Why did you dedicate it, and what is it that you wished for?
Yeah, it was an auspicious day today as the Lord appeared, come and teach us love of God. When I'm passing through St. Lucia, I'm seeing everybody's faces tangled up. Like nobody's smiling, everybody, their faces wrinkled. They are stressed out within, with children, with husband, without money, no work. You know, it makes me feel very bad. So I had to do this fire jagya to help St. Lucia and invite St. Lucian who run in politics also to come and visit and take part in it also, you know, so that to give a little boost up, you know.
So you say you had an invitation to people who are participating in politics to be here tonight as well?
Yeah.
Because we noticed Mr. Shastin was there, so he took up the invitation.
Yeah, so I gave him an invitation. He came visit, yeah, he and his family. And that is was so great. They ate vegetarian food and everything. They ate on leaf and everything. It was amazing, you know.
Did you also invite other politicians as well?
Yeah, well, long time ago, Oni Compton used to come and eat in my temple. You know, he always, Mr. Compton, for all the years he stayed there, he never missed one feast. He always, not here, but in Peru I was, and he was always there, you know. So he was my best friend also, you know, so.
Yeah, finally, tell me about the significance. We noticed that you put a flag on a bamboo. Explain to us the significance of this activity.
Well, after each jagya, if you do the jagya for the country, or for the people, or for whoever you do it for, then you put up the flag, you know. So it signifies the symbol of the place, you know, of the personality that you ask for, you know. That's what the symbol is all about. So you see Godhead is on top of the flag. So in true speaking, we are asking God the Father to lead St. Lucia. Because St. Lucia, sorry to explain you, St. Lucia is 75% Buddhism, black heart. And it's only 25% pure souls in the island, you know. So we are asking God the Father to help us, help them, those that are there, for them not to fall down. Understand?
Now you asked Mr. Shastri to put up the flag. What's the significance of this?
Yeah, because the flag of Krishna that we put up, and he, the symbol of his color is the same. So this is the reason why I asked him to put it up. Yeah.
You know, some people might see this as being political. How do you respond to that?
Oh, well, we all are political. We are the best person to be political, because in truth speaking, we are the ones supposed to lead the country. I'm a Vanapastra, Brahmin, they are the ones supposed to lead. They are the ones supposed to tell you which is right and which is wrong, advisor. The head of the state supposed to take advice from us. Sorry to tell you the secret of Mr. Kamdan, he always came and take advice from me. And he always used to be with me. In Peru, he always used to come. You know, he's very nice. And even when I told him there'll be 14 years St. Lucia will fall down. He didn't want to believe me. Eh? He said, Margaret, where are you going? He used to call me Margaret at this time. Where are you going with this one again? And when it fell, when he had lost the seat, he came and told me, you see that, eh? And after that, he came back. I told him, yes, you'll win it. And he win it back, you know? So there are things that you get to know from the Supreme Lord. Because don't mind, not a blade of grass move outside there without the will of God. You know? If God the Father don't want any blade of grass to move there, it will not move, you know? So
you're not making any, because when you said you spoke with Mr. Compton, you were not making any predictions about elections or about anything that's coming in the future?
Oh no, I don't make predictions. The predictions is secretly within me, you know? Because I know who will win. The same flag I put up there, that's the one that will win.
Yeah. So you're sticking to that?
Yeah, well, that's the one that will win. I know. I know it's the yellow going to win. I don't propagate who, because I don't propagate who, but I know it's the yellow will win, you know? So
the color that you chose there is the color of Krishna, or this is the color that you chose today?
Yeah, that's the color of Krishna. So you see Krishna is on top of it, and look him right there. All his yellow pants, all his costume is of yellow, you know. It has different culture and philosophy, and which is a little bit too secret to explain to you. People follows, you know. Deep within, you may not know, but societies and culture and philosophies, you don't know, you know. But certain use certain colors, and certain use certain other colors, you know. So if it falls down on the hand of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then you can say, yes, that person is the color of that. Like, I will give you a true explanation about it. Most of people, sometimes they are werewolf, and sometimes some of them are the goat. You understand? So if, for example, the goat is red, then it's red. You'll get another cultural man maybe using the red, you know. Sometimes if the werewolf is yellow, then you get the lion, or the, what do you call it, this bird, the eagle, which is Krishna, the eagle that is on top of the bank, every bank door of the bank. Then you can say, well, this person is the same color, you know. So colors means a lot, you know, and at the same time means nothing. You understand? It means nothing. Sometimes it means a lot too.
You have to say a word on that, of course. You're supposed to say a nice word on that.
May you continue flying. And keep blessing St. Lucia.
No, I thought you would ask blessing for Fukuli. Emma, I thought Mr. Chasse would ask blessing for Fukuli. Ask for what? Blessing for Fukuli. He said, may you continue flying.
May you continue
flying. Jai.
Also at the ceremony was a special visitor from Guyana who was fulfilling a promise made 24 years ago to visit St. Lucia and Priestess Anna Sadu.
Okay, my name is Devika Prasad. I am basically a devotee of Lord Krishna from the age of 5, from Guyana and to Suriname. And then I got married, I came to Trinidad, and I lived here. And 24 years ago, I have met Mataji Mandakini, and she told me she's from St. Lucia, and I was being invited here ever since 24 years ago. I was being invited to St. Lucia. Unfortunately, I couldn't have make it. And then I went last December, October, I got promoted to a ticket to India. So I said, okay, I am going to India. And before I left to go to India, I was praying to Lord Krishna. Mataji invited me, and then so, but I am going to India, why not St. Lucia? And I said, no. I should go to India first. And I went to India, and I visit all the holy places, and I pray that I wish to visit Mataji and St. Lucia. And so Krishna fulfilled my desire. I just came back last week in December, and this is only March, and Lord Krishna has really fulfilled my desire, honestly. I felt it's a blessing to be here in St. Lucia. Yeah, this is my first visit. I am really blessed. I am very, very fortunate.
Ahi kamala vasam kutati karvakampati nishimhumi siha patu loki raksata sambrava savagopi sambravaksha pralami raksatu davani nishimhumi disto patu.
Where did you meet her 24 years ago?
I met her in Trinidad and Tobago. And then in 1994, she moved to Guyana to get an India visa to make her first trip to India. And I met her there for the second time. And she said, I am going to India, so I need an India visa. Okay, Mataji, no problem, I will take you. And I did take her around, and I take her to Suriname, and I take her, and she said, okay, I wish to see you in St. Lucia soon. But the soon has been 24 years ago. Ever since I am a little girl, I have a passion for singing. I love singing. I always want to be a musician. I always wanted to have a band. I always have dreams of singing. I want to play all musical instruments. Yes, I have to accomplish, but not all. Because, you know, time, place, and circumstances when you have duties. So I am a family of four. My husband, my two kids, myself. And I love singing. And so from the age of 8, I started to produce CDs. I do CDs, only Krishna bhajans. And it has inspired me Because I have a passion for singing, I only sing Krishna bhajan. So when I go everywhere, I only sing bhajan that people, it will give an impact, leave an impact on that person or to the populations.
That is our show for tonight. We thank you for being with us. I am Bernard Fannis, inviting you to join us again for Calabash Community.